It's Andre from High Performance Academy here. Let's check out what's been going on around HPA over the last week. Right, let me just get this stuff out of the way here. And I just wanted to also bring in a little harness that I've just made up this week for our FJ40 project. So we'll have a quick look under the overhead. And this is a small sub harness that's going underneath the intake manifold on the Toyota 3U ZFE 4.3 litre V8. So the starter motor in this engine is actually buried under the intake manifold in the V between the two banks of cylinders. Under there we've also got two knock sensors. And obviously once the inlet manifold is installed, accessibility is pretty limited. So what I've done is I've made this sub harness here. And this part here, the Autosport connector, that's going to essentially poke out the back of the engine and connect to the main engine harness. The reason I've done it like this is it allows the engine harness to be removed without having to take the inlet manifold off. So everything just passes through our little Autosport connector here, which is a 13-pin 22-gauge connector, size 22 connector. What we've got on this, we've got our two knock sensors. So this is just a Bosch wideband knock sensor. This is the exciter for the starter motor. So this is what we're going to actually power up in order to start the engine. And this here is a 12-volt sense for the alternator, so just a nice neat way of getting the sense voltage into the alternator. So why did I want to show this harness? There's a couple of elements that I wanted to talk about on it. First of all, the starter motor itself. So depending on the specifics of the starter motor solenoid, these can draw somewhere in the region of maybe 10 to 15 amps while we're actually cranking. Obviously, as soon as the engine started, there's no current draw. That can be problematic given that my entire harness essentially uses 22 gauge wire. 22 gauge wire is only going to handle somewhere around about 5 amps. So how do you make 15 amps go into 5? Obviously it doesn't. And because this connector only uses size 22 contacts, we're limited. Now there are other solutions there. There are Autosport connectors that have mixed size contacts in it, and that may have worked, but then that would still require me to run sort of 14 or 16 gauge wire through the harness, which gets a little bit cumbersome, particularly when you're trying to concentrically twist. So the easy solution, which is often overlooked though, is to simply run 322 gauge conductors out to our starter motor, and that way we're splitting the load. Again, sort of 22 gauge wire is going to handle around about 5 amps, so 3 fives of 15. So there we go, we've got our current handling capability for the starter motor. The other aspect with this is our two knock sensors here. Any sort of digital signal like this, we really want to run in shielded cable, just like we would for the likes of our engine position and engine speed signals. This just helps reduce the chance of noise affecting that signal, and obviously these are mission critical signals. So these are shielded cable. There are two core 22 gauge twisted pair shielded. This is just an off the shelf product. It's nice and easy to work with. But that also begs the question of what do we do when we get to the Autosport connector, and I know a lot of people worry about that. It's actually pretty straightforward. What we do is we use a solder sleeve to connect to the braided wire, which is our shield around the outside of our conductors, and then we simply run that solder sleeve with a separate conductor through the Autosport connector, and on the other side we essentially reattach it to the shield. So there is a small section of maybe about 50 millimeters where the shield is interrupted, but I can assure you that doesn't present an issue. If you do want to know more about that, we do actually have a webinar in our archive about how to work with or how to terminate those braided shielded cables as well. All right, I also just wanted to highlight a video that we released. It is a little while back now. We'll head across to my laptop screen on our YouTube channel. This was one of my favorite vehicles from World Time Attack, and it's actually one that I've followed the build of for a fair while. If you're not following Ryan Turk on Instagram already, I highly recommend you do so, and I wish that during this webinar, I could give you a sense of the sound that that engine makes. So this is a Judd V10 that revs to about 11,000 RPM. It is a fan favorite. It's maybe not the fastest time attack car, but it's certainly the best sounding. And in this interview with Ryan, we go into the depths of this particular build, how it occurred, how you actually get access to a Judd V10, and some of the intricacies of actually running that vehicle as well. So if you want to learn more about that, head across to our YouTube channel and check that video out. All right, we'll finish up just with a reminder here about our Nexus R3 giveaway. 15 days left for that giveaway to run. Remember, there's no catches here. Free to enter, don't need to purchase anything. So it is a really great package, over $5,000 in value. Get your name into the draw.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.